understanding of life is one thing, knowledge. Knowledge stays with you. So I built this company out of one thing. No fund. I didn't have a capital. I didn't have no one to fund me. One of the largest media house came to buy me within 1 month of my launch. I didn't sold, I was self-funded. I only traded one thing which I had, and that was knowledge. Since I didn't have people who can work with me, so I traded my knowledge. I told all the people, that guy sitting in the, you know, standing in the corner, for example, he was the first one to join me. He joined me with zero digital marketing knowledge, and almost 6 to 8 months, I could not pay him, except for his food and his place. So all the people who worked with me, they all came like students wherever I went on, they started coming to me. I have been talking to them, I have been teaching them. First 6 months, there was a trade that I will teach you, I will not be able to pay you anything. So the motivation of coming and working with me should be knowledge and not money. So if you're looking for pocket money, you can work with me. If you're looking for knowledge, you can work with me. That's how it started. 37 people came. I didn't have a place to make them sit. So I used to sit in my office in the carpet, and there were only 4 tables. So people used to come in different hours. So 37 people worked with me, and we built this company out of absolutely nothing. So if I can do it, all of you sitting here can do that. So if you're knowledgeable, nothing stops. So that's the basic thing which I learned. I don't practice what a corporate life do. I've been following what my heart says, and things which corporate life have not given me, I try to give it to my people. So I have a criminal lawyer who works with me, he's a business consultant. I have an engineer MBA combination guy working as a designer. And I have an artist right now shooting my content. So in my office, there's no department. I don't try to fit people into a pigeonhole. So people work with something which they love. So I make them discover what they love, and that's the fund of my company. And you must be asking and thinking, so what the clients you work with? So within, I think, third month, World Bank found me. World Bank found me, and we have been working with World Bank since then. We have a very different funder. In fact, I got interviewed last 2 days back when you texted me. I was at the Bombay Stock Exchange, they were interviewing me. I don't have a single salesman. I don't have a business development manager. I don't go out and look for business. I don't have a proposal letter. I always get found. Right now, I'm at the podium talking to you, not because I know Nayan Behra, but my content kept on basking him with lots of things which he sees me on my social media. So because of my content, I'm standing in front of you. Think about it. Just because of my content. So I always get found. And by the way, something very, very important is I don't have a single CV of my people. All the people working with me, I don't have a CV. Because I never interviewed them. Yeah, I never interviewed them. They all came to me, and we spoke for a few days, and then we worked for a few days, and we thought, okay, we share, right? That's how we're working. So I don't believe in CV. So I never look for people, right? So if you go to my website page, it's thedigitalfellow.com, if you try to contact me, you're not able to contact me, because there's no number. You need to Google me and then to find me. So all these things, which I was trying to do, is absolutely digital. If I meet you outside my podium, I'll show you my card, which is an example. This is my card. And this is my name. And it has nothing. No number. No email ID. No Twitter handle. Nothing. Because Google find me 0.46 seconds. If someone finds a person on Google, even if you spell my name wrong, Shubha Broto Chakraborty is very, very difficult. 16-17 character. If you just say Shubha Bro, it will. In 0.4 seconds. So what I'm talking here right now is what I'm talking, I walk the talk. So I absolutely made it digital. So and there will be at least 7 pages of me, end to end. You can try it right now with your phone. And also do one thing. Type your first name and see that Google can understand you. I can bet my life other than one LinkedIn or Facebook picture, nothing will come on Google. Please try, I'm waiting. Yeah, you found it. Try your first name and check whether Google can see an image search. Do an image search, easy to find out, right? When you do image search, it will show your picture and show my picture. And just write Shubho Bro or Bruto, whatever. It will come. So what I can do that, what I did that in my company is that absolutely digital. So no CV, no business, no sales, and I reject. If you go to my contact us me page, in a very bold language it says 97% of the client who come to me, I reject. They don't reject, I reject. Because I don't work with everybody. The reason I could do that is simple. All of you can do that. What I'm talking about right on the podium is nothing French, right? Because I'm also a very, very bad student, right? Believe me. You're all engineers, I guess, right? All of you engineers, raise hands? Okay, more qualified than you, right? So I somehow passed MBA, you know. I scored very bad in my... I never scored more than 3,500 in all my school life. The reason I figured out was that all my school life, till I did my BCom graduation, I failed in a lot of subjects. And somehow in group I used to pass. So right now, someone is wearing a black jacket and talking with a lap of mine is a failure. 1,065 times a failure. It's there on my website, I put it, how many times a failure. So a failure talking to you, right? And build a company. So imagine how all of you can do that, right? So nothing is related. So the idea of life or the understanding of life is one thing, knowledge. Knowledge stays with you. No one takes it out of you. So if you're thinking you got some great number, so 98 marks, 100%, whatever, you thought you'll get a passport from this college and you'll get a good job, God help you. This is the best thing happening in your life. College, or the professors who I see here, whatever I see here is the, you might be thinking, yeah, guys, I'm good, they keep something too much principles. I don't like that professors. This is the best place to work in a college. The last life of happiness ends in college, and it's true. Somehow these guys will be too much pushing you, but one thing is happening, when you go to corporate life with your degree, no one cares about your degree. No one cares about your degree. You can get an interview, but no, there's no guarantee. I see 60% of the interns get sacked or get demoted or thrown away from the jobs because they have an attitude issue. In your certificate, there's nothing called attitude percentage, right? So all of you trying to score in maths and engineering college, and what about your attitude? So people get fired because of attitude, and that is the reason I don't take CV, because CV doesn't give a score of an attitude. So I hire attitude and I build skill. So people who work with me come with zero skill, zero. All I have, whether it's an empty bucket. If it's an empty bucket, I can put content, I can put knowledge, and I can build it up. So that's the fund of life. It's very difficult than what I've been, my corporate life has taught me. So all of you are engineers, right? And how many is MBA? No MBA, right? Business people? One, okay. So let me show you. So I was told to speak on marketing 0.0. So I'll show you the boring slides that I have. Right? It's really boring. So I'm not going to talk of any of these slides, right? So these slides mean nothing to all these people sitting in front of you because you guys are engineers and I'm an MBA. So you can't talk a butterfly with a caterpillar language, right? So we'll not understand. So here, you must be thinking this guy takes 40 minutes going to bore us. So let me dump this presentation into your dustbin, right? Let me talk what marketing is all about. Marketing is nothing but a small video I have. Let's see this, hopefully. After lunch, a 1 minute video will make you wake. I hope it works. Yeah.
What is marketing 2.0? It's an approach that will help you get away from the megaphone the traditional marketers use. These guys haven't figured out that more megaphones not only reduce impact, but actually infuriate people. Unlike traditional marketing, which relies on one-way communications, marketing 2.0 is based on conversations and recognizes that brands are built by communities, not just by companies. This is great news because your community wants to help you grow. And there's more good news because you can trade in your old megaphones for a diverse selection of brand new communication tools. The complicated part is knowing which ones are right for you, how they work together, and how they'll allow you to efficiently return value to your community while increasing sales. Marketing 2.0 requires that you establish an understanding of the new communications landscape so you can select the right tools for your community. The next step is getting three communication structures in place that you may or may not already have at your company. These support a marketing practice. The first is a foundation to collect data, manage relationships, and report findings, all in an accessible way. The second is a communication platform for you and your community to use across touch points. And finally, a marketing lead to harvest leads, insights, and opportunities which can be converted into value and returned to your community. You'll want to get these structures up and running before conducting some research to understand your community, how they prefer to interact with your company, and what they value most. Based on this research, you can identify the most...
The world of marketing has changed. The world of engineering has changed. The world of business has changed. And if you think your certificate is going to help you, no. Even if you score high, a number, maybe a first class, doesn't help you, right? So I've seen lots and lots of failures in life, and I see lots of people who are coming in with greater degree, fail because college or any certificate only make you, it's just a passport to, it's like an icebreaker. It just give you just an opportunity to come and sit and pass preliminary, you know, interview. That's it. When you work, if you are not updating yourself, if you're not changing yourself, God help you. I have seen people at the age of 30, 35 studying. I have people who come who are engineers, MBAs, pharma guys, they're all losing jobs. Yeah. Welcome to the reality, you're going to lose jobs. Because all of you here think that this degree or your certificate or your whatever degrees you have is going to help you and is going to take care of you for the next 20 years? No. Try doing one Google or any online examination. If you try doing that, you will see you are as a hooker. Let me make it very simple. So all of your degrees are going to expire when? When your degrees get expired? It gets expired.
After it's not used.
So, but second job they will ask you, right?
They will ask you for the experience.
They will ask you whether you pass, right? So they will check. There's a credibility check or wherever you go. So your or mine, both of us, our degrees expire when we die. Right? No use? Try doing a digital degree. So normally your and my degree generally lasts for 60, 70, 80 years of time till that I believe. Digital marketing or modern marketing, 2.0, whatever is going to happen, it only lasts for 6 months. Try doing a Google examination. Your certification is only valid for 6 months. Just 6 months. So if you're not doing you're not upgrading yourself. So all of you must be thinking that so all of you have a phone here? Smartphone? When was the last phone bought? 1 year back? Raise hands. 2 years back? 3 years back. So if I put all together, within 3 years you change your phone, right? So you don't use your old Nokia 511, no? Why WhatsApp doesn't work, right? Internet doesn't work, right? And the memory is shorter. And you don't get great pixel picture. There's no selfie camera, right? So when was the last time? So you have been upgrading your phones, right? Every year, every 2 years, right? Thinking that let's catch up with the new thing. And that's how his life is. When was the last time you upgraded yourself? Other than your studies. Other than your syllabus. When was the last time you upgraded yourself? You think that your changing camera is going to get you a job and make you survive? No. If you're not upgradable, I have friends who are all CEOs like me. 99% are struggling to keep their job. 50% have already lost their job. 20% have moved into something other than jobs. Everything in a very shitty state because none of them have upgraded themselves. They have upgraded their car, they have upgraded their phone, they have upgraded their flat, but they have never upgraded themselves, so they are struggling. So this is a huge dynamic changing happening in the marketing and technology world. Technology is going to take a lot of jobs. Technology is also going to create a lot of jobs. So you need to be an upgradable version Today's what, 9th?
10.
So 10th March 2019 version, I try to be valid, and tomorrow I'll try for 11th March Shubhabrata 2019 version. That's how I survive. And that's how I survive for the last four years without working a job, I did few crore by the way. But my car is still an old Wagoner which is 7 years old. I can walk into a bank and buy a BMW. But I am absolutely knowledgeable and I have thrown away all my 27 years degree into a dustbin. All those irons which you saw have no use now. It's irrelevant. Doesn't, no one cares whether you are an iron or not iron. All it cares, are you an upgradable version? So if you are not, life is going to be very difficult for you. So it's not because of marketing changing, the entire scenario has changed. You will find the bank will perish. You will find, you know, 50% of the ATM is going to shut down this year across country. 50% of the ATMs are there, they're going to close down as per the RBI rules because they're all non-profit. No one is going to ATM. It is not the cost of maintaining ATMs is so costly. So everything is going to be a disaster right now. Telecom company, do you have any friends or colleagues who works in telecom? Please look at them. They are in a very dire state. They are all dying. They can't pay their EMI. They can't pay their car because all telecom companies have cut down 60% of the jobs. There's a huge disaster because telecom company paid a huge license 20 years back for a bandwidth of using phone, voice. Now voice is free. They can't stop. No, don't use a WhatsApp voice call. Pay my internet for international. You and I don't use an international phone call. So life has changed very, very fast. So if you think, my life is sorted, I just got my degree, I am so young, and I have enough time, please be prepared to get a job cut. Someone will come and snatch your job. And it is going to happen within the next 1 year time of your job. Because people are going to work maybe more efficiently at less than the price you have been working for. So if you are not modern, upgraded, marketing 2.0 is just one thing. It can be marketing 2.3, 2.4. So do you know Philip Kotler's name? The guy who wrote marketing is a guru. He's an 80-year-old guy. He has thrown his book. He again write his book back. Marketing 2.0. Is he a mad guy, 84 years old world, guy whom, it's like a Bible, it's like a marketing Bible. He has thrown his book and rewrote his entire book because he think, and everybody realized that old theory will not work. So old degree will not work. Great, people who are sitting here must be, have been scoring very high and he thought, wow, this is a great life. I'm going to get a crack a degree, I'm going to crack a college or a better college or a better company. It doesn't work like that. It will never work like that. I see every day, I have around 30,000 LinkedIn connections. It's full for the last 2 years. So I delete around 4 or 5 every night. And there are some 2,000 people in my queue whom I selectively add. Every day, I see lots of kids are coming and asking for jobs. Most of them are engineers, by the way. They're not getting a job within 12,000 rupees or 20,000 rupees. Life is really, really bad. So if you think that you boast of your Snapchat score, how many of you use a Snapchat? Resonance. Only few. So if you think your Snapchat score and you're very cool and you have a WhatsApp, you can do Snapchat, your filters are fantastic, your selfie look nice, God help you. Yeah. You're not going to survive. Because degree and college and certificate doesn't take care of you for the next 5 years time. And the 5 years time, in the next 3 years time hopefully, the first two jobs is going to be a disaster. So if you are following out marketing and everything, if you are not able to upgrade yourself, the way is beyond selling syllabus, you are going to be perishing. Yeah? You're going to perish. So the most important part is, it's not because the forum is on marketing, I'm going to talk about marketing. I can talk on marketing for the next 8 hours. So I speak generally for 8 hour session. So this was only 30 minutes I have. How much time I have, man? Another 5 minutes, 10 minutes?
No, you got.
Fine. So I can talk because I thought, let's not talk French to a German. Right? So let's not talk about marketing. Let's talk about things which comes to me every day on LinkedIn. Hundreds and hundreds of people are flocking and they're asking me, can you get me a job? Most of my companies here, I have 20 people in my team. One of the marketing team are in Delhi, they are on intelligence, they are on marketing automation, they are on, so there's a guy from Bits Pilani who is working with me. The guy who works for Bits Pilani is 23 years old. He was a topper. Most of his friends still couldn't find a job. So Bits Pilani is not that, the best, you know, school we all know among the engineering college. Bits Pilani students are also getting. So do you think all the IIM gets a good job? No. There are many people, at least 15-20 people in IIM each year don't find a job. Because when you get a job, an internship, when you do an internship in a marketing or engineering college or a school or maybe a corporate world, people don't look at your presentation. People don't care how much your percentage. They check your, you know, attitude towards work. And you get thrown out or accepted both ways because how good you are, how you are comfortable, how you are learning, how hungry you are. The moment you are looking at 6 o'clock because or on a Saturday that you have some party, your boss is watching you. You will never get, you will not survive. So most of the interns who get a job generally vanish within the 6 to 7 months of the internship because most of the people don't hire them back. And interns, because I hire only interns. All freshers, all the time. So around, I made it very, very difficult so that interns can survive. I actually make them work with no money so that they understand the motivation is knowledge, and that's how I can see 20 bright people are working with me. And these are the people working for World Bank project. They are interns. They work on a World Bank project. They are working for international projects. So I consult most of my companies who are from Singapore and Vietnam and Malaysia. So these are the people who are working. So how it's happening? It's all happening because all my kids, I don't see the age, that guy and that lady sitting in the last in yellow red t-shirt, clothes, and one more guy here, I can find his sitting picture. These are the people, I have never hired them because of their certificate. He joined me, what, 2 weeks back? 2.5 weeks back, right? So did I saw your CV? No. Did I ask your portfolio? No. Certification and knowledge will not take you far. Match to match 2 years. So if you're not upgradable yourself, if you're not learning from the blogs, if you're not upgrading beyond your syllabus, it's going to be a tough world. Because when you go to a corporate world is going to ask you one thing. Are you a live, renewable, functionable, modern person, or you come from X degree? And it actually doesn't matter which college you are. Believe me. You must be thinking, this college, oh, my ranking is 78, oh, but that college ranking is 21. It means nothing in the corporate world, just nothing. So I have people who are brilliant, who got chucked out because they couldn't perform. And I have people that guy doesn't have a college degree. The college degree has, he doesn't have an MBA degree. He's my mentor, he teaches my engineers and MBA about digital marketing. He's a mentor and a coach. How can he do that? Learning. He learned everything. By the way, I got up 5 o'clock in the morning. So this presentation, what you're seeing here, has been done, the first cut done by him. I have not touched because I slept early. I got up at 5 o'clock. I don't repeat my own presentation. Because all my presentations are posted on social media. Go back and check any of my YouTube. You will never find the same presentation. You know why? Because I challenge myself. When I stand in the podium, I will talk something new which I have not talked in last week. 13th, I'm speaking on Delhi and CII, which I was talking with Nayan. 14th, I'm talking in Bangalore. Every night, I make my own presentation. He helps me, but I read and make my own presentation because I ask myself, am I upgradable? What I talk in the podium, do I act that? So I make my own presentation every day. Like a student, I get up in the morning. And if you see my bio, it never says a seasoned or a marketing guru. I hate that word. I feel I'm an avid reader, I'm a student, I'm learning. 27 years, I have thrown away 20 years, and I think I have a 5 years experience and you're surviving. So if you are not trying hard to upgrade just your phone, God help you. You will have a very bad corporate life. And you will not able to think, money, the first 5 years of your life, you should not look money as a component to decide. Doesn't matter someone gets a job in HUL, someone gets a job in Siemens, someone gets a job in Budapest, doesn't matter. All it matters whether the first job you have a great boss. boss, a great boss is like a school headmaster. Working with a great boss, working with a learned boss, actually, easily, sweetly, 5 years of knowledge. I have worked for, 25, 26 years, I only got four bosses, most of them are idiots. Four are the best guys. Those people, those bosses are still in touch. I can stand in front of you because one of the boss who gave me a chance to stay in Bombay. I'm from Kolkata, I don't live in Bombay. I now sit in Bombay. 7 years I tried to come in Bombay. Successfully failed. I'm ashamed of this guy. I'm going to give up. Eighth time I could do that. So, and I do that with one of my ex-boss in Reliance. He said, we went to Goa for a marketing conference. We were supposed to go back to Kolkata. I said, can you give me 2 days time? He said, what are you going to do? I said, should I tell you the truth? He said, yeah, you don't jelly guy. I said, I want to look for a job. He said, are you mad? 2 days job. So in my time, 15 years back, there was no WhatsApp group. There was no Facebook page. You know what I did? I had a hunger for making networks. So in Nokia, in the system, in the SMS, you can make 5 people group, in case you remember. You can create 5 people group. I used to create 5 people group of my friends and uncles and aunties who should stay in Bombay and get them connected. I should tell them, send them some nice motivational quotes and jokes so that when I call them and I land up in Bombay, they will say, ha, oh, sure, I know you. So I came in Bombay, and while going back from Goa, I gave some 11, I still remember, 2 days, morning to night, from Borivali to Churchgate, I gave 12 interviews, forced interviews. There's no fix. I couldn't get a single one. Then I again called my boss, give me one more day. He was such a motivational human being. He said, oh, don't come to Kolkata because he is looking for you. I said, you are sick. You're right in Bombay. Don't come to Kolkata without an appointment letter. Such motivation. You don't get such bosses in your life. So that boss changed my life, right? So he gave his first ticket to stay in Bombay and look for a job. So that boss is no more a boss. He's my guru. He's like my, so he's from Ahmedabad. Every time I try to run faster than him. Every morning he will send me blocks. In those days, 15 years back, sorry, 17 years back, by the time I could finish one block, 4 blocks used to hit my email. It was so difficult to catch up with him. I understood, I was so weak. I don't understand, he is so super fast. He used to teach us something, such interesting thing which we didn't know. So please, look for a boss. Don't look for a salary. You're not able to survive more than 2 years time. Never look for money as a component for choosing a job. Always look for a great boss. And the boss, how can you find a boss? In 2 days, money is so easy, you know. I can find anywhere. You can talk to Kareena Kapoor, you can talk to, Shahid Kapoor on Instagram, right? You can talk with anyone else. So you can go to LinkedIn and figure out, this company, this guy. Then go to social media and figure out, anyone works at the company and figure out, how's this boss? If you find a good boss, 5 years is stopping. You're going to really learn, learn. Initially, there's a card, I can't tell you, I'm writing a blog on this, it's called Career Trap. Most 99% of people get into that trap. And it starts with first thing. The first two jobs, or the first three jobs, text you or tracks you down. So it happens in the marketing and the digital world because, and in the automation world, there's so much of things happening at a very fast pace, you will not able to survive. By the time you're trying to cope up with LinkedIn, how many of you use LinkedIn? Wow. Now raise hand, how many of you time, or how many of you people in LinkedIn contribute and write? No hands, I can see. One? Okay, out of what, there will be some 70, 100 students here? Okay. Do you think WhatsApp and Snapchat will take your life? You can't manage a LinkedIn. Ask yourself. You want to survive here? And I can bet my life, all of your LinkedIn pictures will be some selfie. They're not a professional picture. Go and check my picture on LinkedIn. So people are HR, check your social media. Life has changed. Your passport size product photographs will not really help you. They check what you do on online. And they check your credibility. Right? You wear a suit in an interview, they check your social media line posting. And they figure out who you are. Life has changed. And it can only happen, they also know how many times they abuse. They also know how many times they're liking which pages. They also know what movies and what things, because there's a social media tool. You plug in and you can see everything about everyone. Such is life. So you can't run away from technology is going to, any footprints is everlasting. Anything you do online, is exposed. So we are all exposed to social media. We are all exposed to internet. You can't run away. So if you think you are smarter by changing your profile, they know everything about you. And there are many tools. Most of them are free tools. I wish I had more time, I can talk to you. The social listening tools, all of you can check back. Look for a good boss or a good company. The moment you do that, your life is sorted for the next 5 to 10 years time. So world is changing. By the way, it's not changing, it's just change. Are you still in 2019 or 2014? I don't know. If none of you are using LinkedIn, I don't think you belong to 2019. You may be cursing me, I really don't care. All of you here are a very old, expired social digital profile sitting in front of you, if you're not using LinkedIn. And all of you are banking on your certificate, it has no use. If you're not reading on content, if you're not reading on blogs, if you don't know what is happening on artificial intelligence, if you're not constantly following up TechCrunch, how many of you follow TechCrunch here? Let me ask. Oh my God, this is what, an MBA student or an engineering college? Engineering college, right? So how come engineering college doesn't read engineering journals? Well, you think you're modern? I don't think so. TechCrunch you don't know. Please go and read TechCrunch. That's your journal. This is why you should survive. That's what your people will ask you. They will ask you what books you read. What movies you'll say, I saw a movie of Ranbir Kapoor. And they will get you a job. Doesn't happen like that. So TechCrunch is one of the best technology magazines. Verge. How many of you have heard the word Verge? And read Verge. If you tell me Verge, right, raise your hand, they will ask you what is in the today's first page. No one. So sad. So if you're an engineer, if your mindset, you know, and nothing wrong with engineer, doctor, or whatever domain, if this is the domain you want to build your life, do you really care about this domain? I don't think so. I care. So I need all the time. If you don't care about the environment you're living in, if you're just trying to look for a job and a salary, God help you, it will go. It will go. Every day, hundreds of people lose jobs because of this attitude. Attitude of, I know all, my life is sorted, I'm just 21, so I have enough time, my dad pays my bill, everything comes free. So how does it matter? It matters to you, it will, in the next 2 years' time, when you lose your job. So please welcome and wake up and get into reality world. If you're not educated enough, if you're not upgrading yourself, such conference means nothing. Such conference means nothing because I will not even teach you, because being an engineering college, you don't even heard of a name called Verge. Ask yourself. Don't you think it's shameful? It is, right? So please wake up. Forget about all this marketing thing. Please get and do what you love. If engineering and mechanics and whatever, civil, whatever you're doing, if you really love it, tell me one top guy who's influenced in engineering. He's a great speaker. No hands? You go and check Instagram, how many followers does he have? Oh, he got a blue tick. Wow, I want a blue tick. Oh, I want more followers. You do that? You think life will help you like that? No. Gary Vee, have you ever heard of a Gary Vee? Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, great. So Gary Vee, please follow Gary Vee. You will understand what I'm talking. Right? Gary Vee, VW, Vaynerchuk. He's everywhere. Just Google, you'll figure out. You are far away from reality. You are in some dreamland, you know? All of you? In a dreamland. All of you think, wow, life is sorted. Disaster is happening as we speak now. Please get yourself sorted, because if you really, it's going to be very scary. I'm not trying to scare you, because hundreds of people come to me for jobs on LinkedIn. And I have created a LinkedIn inbox busting video, which I post on my social media. If you go to Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube, wherever you find me, people are asking me questions. This is my career, what do I do? In case you don't love engineering, there are many people who don't. Something you bring to because of your parents' pressure, mom, dad's dream, whatever. It happens in India, it happens everywhere in the world. If you think, look for something what you love. If you do, look for what you love. Life is going to be horrible, because every time, you look for a weekend, right? Because you look for, I think you got 5 days plus here, 6 days, right? So you look for Sundays. You think I'm a mad guy, I'm talking to in front of you so excited on Sunday at 4 o'clock? What motivates me? It only motivates me that I think is a great opportunity where I can talk to 50, 100 students and wake you up. Because all of you are sleeping nicely with your eyes open, that's it. So enough of Gyan, you can curse me, but you can't ignore me. Please upgrade, forget about this marketing 2.0, at least you become 2.1. Because I see you in 2060s. Baba Adam Zaman, I see here only you are wearing a Levi's jeans, that's it. Okay, life is not going to take you. Please upgrade, upgrade. Otherwise, life is going to perish. Thank you so much.